si yang tadi aku udah keliru, apa kurang? Hi viewer, I welcome you to LNTV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, Lesson Number 22. The topic it is internal land forming processes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today. We are going to look at them. By the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to measure the earthquake and also explain them how it is measured. We start by looking at the instrument that is used to measure the earthquake. This instrument, we refer to it as the seismograph or the seismometer. Types of the seismic waves that are recorded on the seismograph. One, we have the primary seismic waves, which is the P waves. Secondary waves, which is the S waves. And the third one, it is the long waves, which is the L waves. We start with the primary waves. They travel faster, so they will reach the seismograph faster than the other waves. And then they cause the rock in their path to compress and expand in the same direction their waves are traveling. Let us go to the secondary waves. The secondary waves, they are slower than the primary waves. The reason as to why they are referred to as the secondary waves, it is because they reach to the seismograph later after the primary waves. So that is the reason as to why we refer to them as the P waves. Long waves. When we talk about the long waves, they have long amplitude wiggles and they are broad waves. So those are the characteristics. This is the instrument that is used to measure the earthquake. We have the seismograph. As you can be able to see, it has something that is marking. That is how it is measured. Then we have the one that is showing us the P waves and the S waves, like you can be able to see from the diagram. Can be able to see the time when the P wave reached the seismograph, it was 5 seconds, while the S wave reached there 13 minutes. That is 13 seconds. And the way they are releasing. So they are compressed and expanding. Then we have the S waves. You can be able to see how it is moving. It is almost parallel. Then let us look at the measurement of the earthquake by their intensity and magnitude. So we measure the earthquake by use of their intensity and their magnitude. The intensity of an earthquake refers to how strong or hard an earthquake shakes the ground. The Mercalli scale is used to express the intensity of the earthquake with a scale running from 1 to Roman 12. This is how it runs. Roman 1, it is imperceptible. It is only recorded by the instrument. Then Roman 2, very feeble, only felt by people who are at rest. And then Roman 3, it is feeble, sounds like a passing motor car, sunlight, disturbances of loose objects. Then Roman 4, we have the moderate. This is where now we start having the rattling, roaring of noises heard by the people indoors. Movement of the seat and shaking of the beds. Considerable disturbance of those objects. Some sleepers are awakened. Let us go to Roman 5. Rather, strong, most sleepers awakened. Swinging of the suspended object. There is the vibration generally felt in an open, slight movement of heavy. Then, number 6, strong, overthrow large and heavy object, cracks in the ceiling and crumbling of plaster. At number 7, very strong breakage of object, slight damage to the building. Then we have the destructive. This is the gaping cracks in the walls, and some walls brought down. That is about Roman 8. Roman 9, highly destructive, severe damage to the structure, some building completely wrecked. At number 9, number 10, devastating, destructive of numerous buildings and their foundation. Then we go to Roman 11, catastrophic, hardly a storm, structure remains steady. At number 12, it is major catastrophe. Very building destroyed, every building destroyed, a major geographic effect. That is the Mercalli scale. Let us look at the Richter scale. This is used to measure the magnitude of the earthquake. And it is ranges from 0 to 8.9. The higher the scale, the more severe the earthquake is. You can see this. Mercalli scale, the Richter scale, that how it ranges. Then activity, state two scales that are used to give the magnitude of the earthquake. And number 2, state the instrument that are used to measure the earthquake. For more information, you can refer to the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 2, that edition. You can also get us through the SMS. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. And also, you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to LM TV. Thank you.